Hey guys, Alicia here, where I am all about making a passive and supplemental income. I wanted to do a video today and show you how to upload a digital listing to Etsy. This is going to be pretty basic and not too in-depth because there's so many other things and so many other videos that I would like to do to go more in-depth when you're listing on Etsy. If you watched my previous video on how to convert files from JPEG to SVG to DXF to, you know, by using online file converters, that is what I want to show you. Right now I am in Cricut Design Space and I want to show you that they do actually work. So we're going to go right here to upload an image, and this is my folder here. This folder right here is going to be the folder that I upload to Etsy for, you know, my digital files that they can purchase and download. Right here is our online file. This is our SVG file. So when I go to click on this, here it is right here. And then I'm going to save my image. Okay. And I'm going to go here. And then when I go to upload and insert the image, here it is here, just so everybody can see. So these do work. This is an SVG file, and I just wanted to show that so that, you know, you could use, you know, understand how that works. So you can upload a link, you know, so you can use online file converters and they will work. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and close out of this. I don't need to save it or anything like that. Was just for the purposes of doing that. So the next thing I'm getting ready to go over is, and if you didn't watch my previous video on how to add a watermark to your digital images, I'm gonna link those two videos below, the one with the watermark and the video on how to convert files using online file converters. I just use Conversio. So right now, when I go to upload this photo, it's going to tell me that, you know, the image needs to be 1,000 pixels in width and 800 pixels tall. But if I do that, it's going to distort the image, and I don't want that. So I'm just going to go ahead right here, and this is the image right here with my watermark. And I'm going to upload it. So this is my thumbnail, and it's going to say listings look best with photos at least 750 pixels wide. It's telling me that, but yet at the same time, to me, you can see everything in this photo. I don't feel that I'm going to need to do anything different to it, even though that they, you know, like I said, if I were to make this wider, it's going to distort my original digital image. So, you know, even though the thumbnail is a little bit in there, I think sometimes you can go in and try to adjust the thumbnail, but it's really, you know, not going to do any good because people can click on this and they can see this image. So I know a lot of people may disagree with me here, but I don't want my image being distorted. Okay, so now I'm gonna go down here, and in the title, this is a whole nother video that I would like to do because you have 140 characters to use and you want to take this entire thing if possible. But for the purposes of this video, so that it's not long, I'm just going to put just a girl boss building her empire SVG file. Okay, now this is not normally how I would name a title, because I'm going to do a whole separate video on keywords and, you know, things like that. So I'm just trying to show you how to upload a digital item. So right here, we're going to put who made it. I did. It doesn't matter if it's a handmade product or a digital product, I made it. So I'm going to click that. What is it? It's a finished product. When did you make it? And I usually just put made to order. Category, let's see. I'm going to type in digital. And I'm going to select right here, digital. And illustration. Okay. I'm going to leave these alone on primary color, secondary color, you know, things like that. And also I'm going to leave the height. Okay. So right here, this is a very important step. We're going to click digital. Okay. So we're going to put into our description here, this is a digital product. Nothing will be shipped. I'm making this very brief, guys, just for the sole purposes of the video, just wanting to show you quickly how you can upload digital files to an Etsy listing. So I'm just making this. Like I said, I'm going to do a whole separate video soon on keywords and how to do the title and the description, you know, things like that. So just keep that in mind before I get any thumbs down on the video. Okay, so then I'm just going to put just a girl boss building her Empire SVG file. Also includes PNG, which is our transparent background. The JPEG. And I'll just put the PNG and JPEG. Okay, so once again, you want to take full advantage of this description. So I'm just doing this just to show you how you want to do it. Once again, down here in the tags, you want to take full advantage of this tag section. So, you know, the word SVG is searched so many times, you know, you really don't want to, you can put SVG and then I can put SVG file, but you also want to get a little creative and put, you know, like Cricut cut files, you know, you can put silhouette cut files. There's so many things that you can do. Once again, that's a whole another video. Okay, so I don't really need to add materials because this is a digital product. However you want to price it is up to you. Usually for, you know, my SVG files, I do not charge a whole lot for those. We'll just say $3. But the thing is on the quantity, you can put 999 available and you can sell the same thing over and over again. Okay. So right now, down here, this is where it says digital files. This is only going to show up whenever, you know, you are doing a listing with digital files. Okay. So this is where we're going to upload these three files right here. So I'm going to first upload this one. Okay. And then I'm going to go here. I'm going to upload my PNG. This is our transparent background. And then we're going to upload this file. And these are all of our files. So when someone goes to purchase this, they are going to, this is what they're going to receive in their email, and it's an instant download, and then they can have it. And as I showed you at the beginning of this video, You can see that the online converter files, they do work easily in Cricut Design Space. Okay, so we're just going to click Save and Continue. And it's telling me I need to fill out some more information. But basically, that's it, on how you do it. You just want to make sure the main thing when you're uploading digital files is that you, when you go here, you want to make sure that you select digital. And then whenever you select digital, it's going to come down here, and this is where all of your files are. And also, don't forget, it's very important that you have the watermark on your first photo. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. Somebody mentioned something about dimensions, and, you know, when it's like an SVG file, it really doesn't matter on the dimensions as long as it's not like huge. As long as it's in proportion is the main thing, you know. But people can also use this file for like print on demand. A lot of people are into, selling the t-shirts. They can use this file to drag over onto t-shirts. They can use it to drag on over onto a coffee mug. You know, the possibilities are absolutely endless on what you can do with this file. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and also subscribe to my channel. I'll be adding a lot more videos on Etsy and, you know, how you can make a passive income doing that. And, you know, I also will be branching out soon on several other ways to make passive income online. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I hope everyone has a great day.